Hello everyone, Namaste. Thank you for watching my videos. I hope all of you are doing good. Today I am sharing recipe of butter paneer masala. Butter paneer sabji you can have with naan, paratha, roti and basmati rice. I have used store bought frozen paneer, that's why I have soaked it in water. If you have fresh homemade paneer, then there is no need to soak it. If you like the recipe, then do share and subscribe. A very happy Mother's Day to all of you. Butter paneer masala is very easy to make. So let's get started. In 2 cups of warm salty water, we'll add the paneer cubes and let it rest for 10 minutes. So now let's make the gravy. On medium flame in a pan, we'll heat butter and oil. And this will add 4 to 5 whole red chilies. Now in this we'll add the slices of onion as well as ginger and garlic pieces. Also we'll add the cashews. Once the onions are sauteed, then we'll add tomato pieces. This mixture will add the salt to taste. We'll cover this mixture and let it cook for at least 5 minutes. So now after 5 minutes, we'll see the tomatoes have become very soft. We'll let this mixture cool completely and then we'll put them in the blender and blend it to make a fine paste. We'll keep this mixture aside. We'll remove the soaked paneer cubes from the water. Now on medium flame, in a kadai or a wok, we'll add 2 teaspoons of butter as well as 2 teaspoons of oil. Let the butter melt and then now we'll add 2 bay leaves as well as 1 big cardamom and 2 small green cardamom and small piece of cinnamon. We'll just saute them for 5 seconds and remove them. Now we'll add the finely chopped onions in this and saute it. Once the onion turns brown, we'll add red chili powder. Also, we'll add the cashew, onion and tomato paste in this and mix it nicely and let it cook on medium flame. 2-3 minutes, stirring it continuously. Once we see the bubbles forming on the surface, then we will add at least 1 to 1.5 cup of water in this. Here I am using the same blender jar, so that whatever is stuck in the jar will also be used. Now we'll cook this for at least 2-3 minutes more, stirring it continuously on medium flame. Then we'll add the paneer cubes in this and mix it nicely with the gravy. Again we'll cook for 2 minutes. We'll also add the kasuri methi as well as garam masala and let it cook for a minute. We'll add salt to taste. Once we see the bubbles forming on the surface, we'll put the gas off and then we'll add fresh cream in this and mix it. Butter paneer masala is ready. Let's serve it. Here I have used a small cute kadai. We can also decorate it with fresh cream and garnish it with cilantro. So our butter paneer masala is ready. You can have it with naan, roti, paratha and basmati rice. See you next week with another recipe. Thank you.